A jail guard is accused of a heinous act against an inmate, one that the inmate says left him with deep wounds and permanent scars. Well, now that inmate has filed a federal lawsuit. Action 7 News reporter Lana Greenfogel has a story you'll only see on 7.
Nobody deserves to be raped in jail. Nobody deserves to be tortured at the hands of a correctional officer.
He's by no means an angel, but his lawyers say he never deserved to live through hell.
No one deserves the kind of treatment our client received, period.
29-year-old Lucas Collin from Espanola was arrested for driving without a license and trying to run away from the officer. Instead of the officer taking him to jail in Riariba County, he ended up in the wrong jail in McKinley County.
He's been extremely traumatized by what happened.
There, his lawyers say his rights were violated. Collin says one day a jail guard suspected him of hiding cigarettes. He says the guard made him strip down in front of other inmates and ordered him to squat and cough to see if Collin was hiding a cigarette in his behind.
Make him get completely naked and humiliate him.
And when that wasn't enough, Collin says he was handcuffed and then the guard shoved his hand up Collin's rear end. The guard never found a cigarette.
It says a lot about a country and about a society that treats human beings with dignity and treats prisoners with dignity.
Collin screamed in pain and says he was so badly hurt he had to have surgery to repair his rectum, and emotionally.
It's affected him mentally. He's had flashbacks.
Collin's attorney says when he was a young boy, he was raped by a close member of his family.
He should never have been treated like he was treated.
When Collin was finally released from jail in Gallup, he told his attorneys he was dumped off on the side of the road, not in his hometown of Espanola, but in Albuquerque.
No one should ever have to go through what he went through, ever.
Collin has filed a federal lawsuit against the jail wardens, the guards, the officer who initially arrested him, as well as McKinley and Riariba counties. Now, an attorney representing McKinley County says these allegations, including the rape, are all false and have no foundation. Reporting in Santa Fe, Alana Greenfogel, KOAT Action 7 News.
Collin has a long criminal history, including burglary, auto theft, DWI, and shoplifting. His lawyers say he's currently in jail getting a psychological exam so the courts can decide how to move forward with his current